What's up, my friends? A few weeks ago, I released a video on how you can overcome TV and video game addiction. And inside of that video, we talked about the seductive and addictive power of simple, actionable KPI dashboards. One of the main questions that I got in response to that video, and by that, I mean I got one question in the comments, guys. Come on. But the question was, all right, sounds great, but how do I actually make one of these KPI dashboards for myself? How do you build the dashboard? What? How do you build it? So in this video, I'm gonna give you a really quick rundown on how you can select the right metrics and KPIs to track in your business and your life. And then I'll show you how to put those KPIs and those metrics onto a personalized dashboard for yourself. So you have a simple dashboard that you can reference to every single day that lets you know exactly what you should be working on in your business and how effective you're actually being. And best of all, guys, you do not need to spend a penny to make this happen. It is absolutely free. In fact, what I learned while researching to shoot this video caused me to actually switch over all of our paid KPI tracking and dashboard solutions over to this free version I'm going to show you right now. So stay tuned and you'll see exactly how we set this up. But before we get into all of that, we should probably talk about what is a KPI and why might you want a dashboard to track them. A KPI dashboard is a simple visual overview of all of the different KPIs, the key performance indicators that are driving the growth and success of your business. There's not a ton of value to a KPI dashboard when you are just getting started, but as soon as you figure out how your business is going to actually grow and make money, you're going to start to figure out that there's these repeated activities that lead to predictable outcomes inside of your business. At that point, you can start to reverse engineer your growth and figure out what are the actual metrics, what are the actual data points that indicate if we're doing well or not, if we're growing or not. And that's when KPIs and dashboards really become the most valuable, is when you have so much chaos and so much activity and you just need to cut through the clutter, cut through the chaos, and get a clear vision of what the most valuable thing to work on next will be. When do we want to start thinking about KPIs and dashboards? Well, the reality is you already have KPIs that are driving your behavior right now, whether you realize it or not. Have you ever noticed that if you start to track any number over a consistent period of time, even a few days, whether it's your weight, the number of steps you're taking every day, the mileage counter in your car, your brain will actually start to restructure your behavior and optimize around whatever number you are tracking. So all of a sudden, you start taking the stairs, you start walking that little extra bit, and you get excited about it because it's going to drive up that KPI that you're tracking. Whatever gets measured gets managed, and subconsciously, your brain is going to start to re-optimize your behavior around driving up the metrics that you're tracking and looking at often. So make sure you consciously choose the metrics that matter to you and figure out a way to track them often and look at them consistently. Now, actually figuring out what KPIs you want to track inside of your business is a complex and big subject. I read an entire book on it just researching this video and building out our dashboards. I'll leave a link to this book below because it was really, really good. But let me give you a quick rundown here right now on how to actually pick the best KPIs to track inside of your business. KPIs are meant to change your behavior and show you exactly how effective your actions have been. They should be quantitative, meaning you can quantify them and count them and say, this event or this thing happened this number of times. Most people start out with bad KPIs that really aren't indicators of the performance of their business. Having quantitative metrics is kind of the first level of a good KPI, and then the next level is making sure that that KPI actually drives the performance of your business. A lot of people end up picking vanity metrics, which are numbers that might make you feel good and sexy, but are not actually correlated with the success or growth of your business. For instance, you've got a lot of people who are focused on their Facebook page or their YouTube subscribers when these things are not really causing the revenue growth inside of the business that they're looking for. You want to find what's called the leading indicators, the events and the actions that actually cause the outcome that you're looking for. For instance, we talked about revenue being a KPI for all businesses earlier, but that's not really a good KPI to track on your KPI dashboard. It's best to find the events and actions actions that actually cause revenue to go up, and then track the performance of those as your KPIs instead. And the very best KPIs are what's known as efficiency metrics. And you create these by combining multiple KPIs together and crunching those numbers into a ratio or a percentage or something like that. And the reason for this is because it's actually really easy for any business to drive up any metric at the expense of other key metrics in the business. So if you're just measuring new sales calls or new sales meetings, thinking that that is the leading indicator for revenue, you're probably going to end up eventually filling up your calendar with tons of unqualified leads that are just going to be a complete waste of time, and you're going to tank the profitability of your business working harder than ever before. And that's the risk of picking a bad KPI. It can actually drive bad behavior subconsciously, and you won't even realize it. It might be better to measure the percentage of prospects converted from those meetings that you do have, because that's going to drive the efficiency and profitability that you're really looking for. Then you could measure the percentage of website users that are converting into those meetings in order to fill that pipeline more efficiently and profitably. And your KPIs will definitely change over time, or there might be a certain time frame that you're focusing on a KPI and then you forget about it for a year or two. So actually picking the KPIs is a big conversation. Like I said, we'll do another video, we'll do a guide on the Startup Pros website, something like that. But once you have the KPIs that are going to drive your behavior, you're going to want to track those really simply and easily and quickly. Again, the reason why these video games are so addictive is because you can really depend on the KPI dashboards, and you know there's nothing missing. You know that that's how you're going to drive the success inside of this universe. So how do you automate this into a video game-like dashboard that you can reliably depend on to change your behavior in great, profitable ways? Previously, we used paid tools like Clipfolio, and there's a lot of alternatives like Scythe and Gecko Board. There's lots of tools like this out there now. But all of these different KPI dashboard tools actually pull in all the different data being generated around your business and allow you to visualize that data in really slick little automatically updated dashboards. So we would use paid tools like this along with the native features inside of all of the other tools that we used. But the problem with all of these paid KPI dashboard tools is they all have tons of limitations on what you can actually do with them. So we still ended up wasting a lot of time jumping into the native analytics features inside of all the other tools that we have, such as HelloProfit or vidIQ, Spotify, Google Analytics, Google Search Console. Most people's data is all over the place, and the truth is these paid KPI dashboard tools really don't solve the issue. It's still scattered, and you're still wasting so much time going around picking out pieces of data from all these different places. So what is the free solution that solves all of these problems and makes this really easy? My friends, it is called Google Data Studio, and I've known about it for a long time, but I haven't really understood how powerful it is until researching it for this video. Google Data Studio is completely free, and it allows you to automatically import data from tons of different sources. Google Analytics, YouTube Analytics, all the different Google tools are free to import data from automatically, and then there's hundreds of additional data sources if you're willing to pay a few bucks for them. But here's the thing, you can also pull in data from Google Sheets. So what does that mean? You can just pull that data into Google Data Studio, and you've effectively created a very, very cheap, automatically updated KPI dashboard. So in setting up this video, let's jump into my computer and I'll just show you really quick. I created this really simple Startup Bros KPI dashboard. And as you can see, I'm pulling in data from all sorts of different places. This is Google Analytics right here. You know, you can actually go here to resources, manage data sources, and we can see I'm pulling in a few, you know, I have my KPI dashboard data that I just showed you. So a lot of the actual, you know, sheets and metrics and KPIs on this dashboard are being powered, not completely automatically, but I do have a virtual assistant that is, you know, there's a reminder, an automatic task that they go through, fill out all of the data. Once I have the data in a spreadsheet, I can then crunch those numbers into the KPIs that are most important to me. So Google Data Studio is a pretty simple tool. Like, I'm not a programmer. I barely know what I'm doing here. And I just spent probably 5 hours on this one right here. And most of the time was probably spent just figuring out what KPIs I really wanted to track inside of this business. Google Data Studio has a thriving community of people building and sharing templates and data sources and all sorts of different technical things that make it really easy for entrepreneurs like you and me to quickly get the value out of a tool like this. I'll also leave a link below for the Google Data Studio template gallery, But as you can see here, there are tons and tons of different reports that you can literally jump in and start using right now. So let's say I wanted to utilize this user journey report inside of my business. It is so darn simple to do this. All I have to do is open up the template, click make a copy. Then you're going to hook up your data sources, right? So hook up, okay, it wants my Google Ads and it wants my Google Analytics and it wants my Google Search Console data. And if I didn't have these already set up, it would guide me through the process of just going and connecting these. It's very simple to set up new data sources for most of the different tools, especially Google tools. And again, anything that doesn't have a connector, you're just going to use Google Sheets and a virtual assistant to automate that as much as you can. So let's go ahead and copy this report. And what you're going to see is Google Data Studio is automatically going to map over to all of my different tools and my data. And this report is now going to be my report, and it's all my data now. How impressive is that? How incredible is that? We just did that completely for free, whereas Clipfolio, Syfe, GeckoBoard, there's so many tools out there that charge you an arm and a leg to do this sort of thing. So there are literally thousands of these different reports that you can pull out and use in your business, not only inside of the gallery itself, but you can also use Google to find tons of different templates that other people have created as well. Just head to Google and type in Google Data Studio templates, and you might want to throw free in there too. But there are lots of paid ones out there as well. Now, you can waste a whole lot of time going through all of the different templates that are out there. And most of the templates are people showing off their skills. So they're going to be really, really complex. Whereas the magic of your KPI dashboard is going to be the simplicity, the focus. So what I'd recommend for you is starting with a really, really simple KPI dashboard with just a few metrics that you're absolutely sure are going to drive the success of your business. So for instance, I am pretty sure that the number of people hitting my website, the amount of organic traffic we're getting, the amount of YouTube views we're getting, that is going to drive ultimately how many people know about the Startup Bros brand. And those are definitely key performance indicators that I want to keep an eye on. Now, obviously, like SEO and content marketing is one of the main things we do here at Startup Bros. So inside of the organic traffic metric, there's going to be thousands of different metrics that I can look at in a separate SEO dashboard that is just about driving that metric up. But ultimately, you as the executive of the company, you need to have a dashboard that tracks the performance of every single department, every single activity in one metric, one efficiency metric. Once you've got your executive dashboard done, you're going to start to be able to see how these KPI dashboards change your behavior already. Now, we are not going to go too deep into how to actually set up these different graphs and charts in this guide. If you guys do want more information on that, feel free to comment below and we'll do some future videos on that. But I will say I am not a developer and I'm not very good with this kind of thing. And I figured it out in an afternoon. So I think any one of you out there can make this dashboard in a weekend and you can customize it. You can put a few of your metrics in there. And just having that dashboard is going to be a whole lot better than jumping around to 50 different sources of data, which is what most people are doing right now. And once you have your executive dashboard up, there's going to be a big temptation to just start creating more KPI dashboards, because you're going to see how powerful and awesome these things are. But that's really what you want to avoid here, because the magic of KPIs is that you have just one or two or three at the very most numbers that you are focusing on at any given point. So I think the right way to do this is just build your executive dashboard first. And then once you're done, let that sit for a few days, look at it for a few days, and then you'll start to decide, okay, I need to spend the next 30 days working on this KPI. I need to drive this KPI up. So let's say for the next 30 days, I decide that that YouTube views are the KPI that I want to drive up and focus on. At that point, it's going to make sense to go out and build a second dashboard, a new dashboard for that separate business activity. YouTube video views are ultimately the KPI we're trying to drive, but there's all these different things that actually cause that to go up, right? The number of videos published, the amount of comments that are posted, the number of times you guys hit the like button. All of these metrics and data points are relevant and helpful, but you don't want to look at them often. You only want to look at these things when you're actually focusing on that core KPI. This is how you stay focused as your business grows and continually keep on growing faster and faster. So let's say I decide YouTube video views is what I'm going to focus on for the next 30 days, and maybe I'll spend a few hours building a KPI dashboard to track my effectiveness inside of there. So all you have to do is go up to the top left in Google Data Studio and just click add a new page, and you can add a new page. And as you can see, here's like my YouTube page right here. I have a bunch of stuff on here already, but let me show you how awesome YouTube Data Studio is. So you'll start with a completely blank page here, right? And you can, again, go through the gallery. You can go through Google and start searching for a bunch of different templates. But what I like to do is bring up all of the different templates I can find for whatever I'm looking at. So if I'm looking at building a YouTube dashboard, I'll bring up all the different templates of YouTube dashboards out there. And what you can do with Google Data Studio is so impressive. You can actually just copy and paste and click and drag and literally steal all of the different metrics and graphs and charts inside of these templates and just put them inside of your dashboard and really quickly build a next level KPI dashboard. So let's say this data source one I like a lot, right? So we're going to make a copy of this and we're going to plug in our data just like we did before. And I don't know what the difference between these two are, so I'm just going to plug in my Google Analytics again because I don't care about anything but the YouTube report here. There's three reports here. So once you've made a copy and you've hooked up your data, you can literally just go through and copy and paste what you want, right? So I'm going to go to the YouTube report of this template here, and we can see the YouTube channel data right here. And we got this nice little scorecard, and we have this chart here. And look at this. This is really cool. The little, I don't even know what this is called, but there's some kind of cool scatter plot here that shows me some really cool information. This will kind of help you to see the outliers in where your subscriptions are coming from and where your watch time is coming from. So this is really interesting, and I want that on mine. So let's go ahead and go over to my new KPI dashboard here, and I'm literally just going to press Control V, and now I have it right here, and it's hooked up with my data. And how impressive is that? Like, I don't even have to know how to use this. So here's another template here. Let's go ahead and grab this YouTube data. This is coming from a spreadsheet, interestingly. So I don't, there's probably a guide somewhere on how to use that one. Let's make a copy of this one. And as you can see, this one is just using YouTube Analytics data. So I have that set up. Let's copy that report. Now we're going to have that report with all of our data instead of the templated data. And as you can see, here's all of our information, right? So let's say I really like this top videoed watch thing with this little filter chart, because I have no idea how to build any of this. I do not know how to build this little filter thing or this chart with the number or the pages. I have no idea how to build that, but I definitely want it for my YouTube dashboard. So I'm just gonna click Control C on that, come over, Control V, there you go. And all of a sudden we have that with our data now as well. So you can literally just go around and cannibalize and kind of rip apart all of these existing templates and use all of these elements for your dashboard. So let's say I really like these cards up here as well. And once you have this stuff in here, you can obviously go through and start formatting it differently. You can even edit. Let's say on here, I don't care about annotations clicked. Maybe I care about a different metric. You know, so let's look at subscribers instead. I don't really know what I'm even doing here, but I just want to show you guys. So here's user subscriptions added. Metric Y instead. Let's look at likes. So you got to play around with these things. And, you know, see what's going to be good for your business. Again, choosing the KPIs and what to focus on is super important. But over time, as you focus on different KPIs and continue to build out different dashboards to track the different activities inside of your business is just going to continue to grow and grow. And hopefully you're able to bring on team members as you grow and hand off dashboards to these different team members and say, hey, here's how we're going to manage your success is these set of metrics right here. So guys, that's it for this video. It's probably a little bit longer than I intended. We kind of turned this into a mini masterclass on how to select the right KPIs, why KPIs are even important, and then how to build those into a free dashboard to not get ripped off by all these paid tools that really aren't that good. And one little bonus tidbit, you can really automate the tracking of any piece of data inside of Google Analytics by sending events into analytics and tracking goals in analytics. So keep in mind, you know, with Google Sheets, you're going to be able to import data directly into your Google Data Studio dashboard, and it's going to automatically update from that. But the next level up from that is just figuring out how to send the data as either events or conversion data, goal data, into Google Analytics, and then you can use Google Data Studio to just track the number of events, or you can start to say, okay, you know, how many conversions did we have divided by how many users were there? And that's your site-wide conversion rate, right? So Google Data Studio, honestly, so much more powerful than these tools that I'm spending thousands of dollars a year for anyways. So I'm switching over all of my KPI dashboards into Google Data Studio, and I'd recommend you start there and finish there as well. Hopefully this video helps. And if you guys want to see more content like this, definitely like, subscribe, leave some comments below. As you've seen, even one comment can get a whole little masterclass video made for you. So to the one person that commented and requested this video, hopefully this helps. And to all of you, good luck building your KPI dashboard. Let me know below if you have any trouble. I can definitely point you in the right direction. And guys, you are so on the right track to success thinking about this stuff and building out a KPI dashboard for yourself. So build out your dashboards, pat yourself on the back, and let those dashboards start to guide your behavior. Awesome stuff, guys. We'll see you in the next video. Thank you for watching. Thanks a lot. I don't know why I'm praying now all the time. Apparently, much love, y'all. Was it like Sammy Sosa that did that?